Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. If this is your first video, hi, I'm Elena, and this is The Organized Money, where we talk about planning life and managing money. Today's video is going to be my monthly plan with me. We are going to be setting up for the month of April, and I wanted to do a quick flip through of each planner and talk about what's working and what's not working. So let's go ahead and get started. My first planner is my faith planner, and the first thing that's working for me is moving this planner to the very front, because when it was at the back of my planner, I would usually forget about this section. But now that it's at the front, it's the very first thing that I do when I open up my planner. So that's definitely working. So I'm going to keep it there. My table of contents is working for me. With my faith planner, I am just using my monthly spread to keep track of my faith routines, which is to meditate, journal, and pray. I have been doing that every single morning. And then I do the verse of the day on my actual spread, and that all has been working for me. I like to write myself notes on the monthly spread of the planner. This is kind of just letting me know what I want to do for the very next month. And here I just wrote to add your routines to my monthly spread, because that was working for me. Adding the verse of the day was working for me, and that I wanted to start adding faith journal insert sheets. So this is for my Bible study. I do want to start adding additional sheets as an insert in here so that I can jot down the different things that are coming up in Bible study or sermons or different things that I want to reflect back on. I also wrote here that I want to set an intention to meditate and journal for the next 30 days. So this is just letting me know what I want to do for the month of April. I'm going to pull out the month of April in my faith planner and pop these pages in, and then I will probably take out March, all up except the last week. March is not completely done. I still have Saturday and Sunday to do. So I'm just going to keep this very last week in here until I finish that. But I am going to take out everything else so that my planner isn't too bulky. So for the month of March, also in my faith planner, I didn't use any stickers, but for April, I believe that I'm going to try and add a few just to liven up the spread and have a couple of stickers throughout. The next planner is my catch-all planner. So let's talk about what worked and what didn't work for this month in my catch-all planner. First thing that worked was having all of my events at the top on my currently page. I did like looking at the sheet and checking off things as they happened. The thing that didn't work though was having my habit trackers at the very bottom. I wouldn't come back to this sheet on a daily basis. I would only look back on it maybe on a weekly basis. So for next month, I am going to add my habit trackers on my actual insert sheet like I did for the month of January, and not at the bottom of my currently page. So I'm going to change that. The next thing that I'm going to change is having my content schedule on my catch-all planner. I wanted to try this out to see if I would like it, but I did not like it at all. Definitely want to keep these things separate. It was too much, too cluttered, and it was really overwhelming my brain. So I am going to separate things back out, only keep events and appointments on this particular calendar, and keep my content on my business planner. So that's the first thing that I'm going to change. Everything else is going to remain the same. I have been loving this planner. This system has definitely been working for me. Oh, I am going to start adding insert sheets for my to-do list. This has been helping me out so much so that I don't have to flip back and forth through different planners. I will go through all of my planners at the beginning of the day, and then I am just jotting down one to-do list from each section of my planners. So I look and see what I have to do for my catch-all, and then I go into my social media planner. I will add different things there. Personal planner, add everything there. So now I have a master to-do list of what I need to do for my planners. And that avoids me having to flip back and forth. And I absolutely love this. So this is definitely moving forward to April. I'm going to do that. Another thing that I'm doing, and I pointed this out in, I want to say last week's video, is I've added a little notebook to my planner. This is mainly for any meetings that I'm having. I can jot down different notes without having to flip back and forth within my planner. Because most times when I'm in my planner, I want to look at my schedule, I want to look at my to-dos. If I need to use my notes section, it makes it more difficult. So having this little small notebook where I can keep track of all of my meeting notes makes it so much easier for me to stay on top of everything. And I still have it on me at all times because it's added to the front pocket of my planner. So let's add in the month of April. And for my catch-all, I am going to try and keep in March for a little bit longer and see if I could keep both months in here. We'll see how bulky it is, but I am going to try and keep 2 months in here instead of one to try and be able to look back and forth if I need to. The next section is my future dated section, and this has definitely been working for me. This is where I keep additional calendars and I can kind of jot down different things that's coming up because I only have the current month in my planner at all times. So having this helps me to pre-plan and future plan different things that's coming up. And so this has definitely been working. I've just jotted different things down. Definitely gonna keep this in here. Nothing is going to change in this section. Same thing with my business planner. The very first thing that you see when you flip to it is my future dated section for this planner. This is my content calendar. So I'm just planning what's coming up for my content, and this has really been working for me as well. I also have my YouTube tracker in here. Love this. Definitely going to keep this. And then we get into my business planner. For this planner, I did go through a couple of variations of my headers, but for the most part, this section definitely has been working for me. I've just been keeping different ideas, outlines, things I want to film, things I need to do, my statistics, all within this planner, and it has been working out really well. So I'm just going to add in the month of April in here. And this is a dashboard planner that I have been using, and I really like the dashboard planner for business planning. You know, I'm gonna see if I can keep 2 months in here. The next planner is my personal planner. Now, this one has gone through a bunch of changes throughout the course of the month. I ended up switching it to a vertical style planner, and that's because I just wanted something different from the dashboard style that I was using. So previously, it was a dashboard planner, and I had the different sections kind of listed out, labels the exact same way that I was doing with my business planner, but I decided to switch it up and use a vertical style planner for this, and so far, I have been loving it. I only have been using it for this particular week. Last week, I was using it for my overall routines. I didn't like how that was working out for me, so I did switch it and see if I could use it for my personal planner, and I am loving this so far. At the very top, I am keeping track of all of my health items. So my sleep, my weight, my workout, breakfast, lunch, and dinner, and then water, like how much water I am drinking throughout the day. And then at the bottom here, I am just keeping track of different things that are coming up with our house or with the family. Now, I do have a completely separate planner that I am using for all of my family stuff, memory keeping, meal planning, and other things that are coming up with us. I do have another separate planner, but this is the one that I carry around with me all the time. So since this is the one that I carry around with me, I do have some things in here related to that as well. So those two planners kind of overlap, my family planner and this personal planner. The information overlaps in both of them, but it's absolutely fine because that planner just has more details of different things that I want to do with the family. And like, we're going to the zoo this Saturday. I have pictures in there. I have just more detail in that planner. So this one is mainly like the overview of like health, home, and family all mixed in one so that I could have it in my overall planner that I have on me at all times. So this system is really working out well. I do love the vertical style planner, so I am going to be using this exact same planner for next month. I am going to be adding in meal planning and my trip preparation for the month of April. So we are taking a family trip next month, so since that's the case, I am going to add that in for the month of April as well. This little section just kind of reminds me of the different things that I want to do and add into this planner. And if I am able to keep 2 months in here consistently, then that means I can start decorating this spread. I usually don't decorate my currently page for the very next month because I always end up taking it out. But if I am able to keep 2 months in here instead of one, then I will start decorating this, and that should be fun. So on my monthly spread, I am going to keep track of my meals, and then we are going to do the exact same thing that I did for the month of March on my weekly. So be my health at the top, and then different things that are going on with our home and our family at the bottom here. The very next section is my budget planner, and nothing's going to change about this planner. I absolutely love this planner, which is always the case with the ones that I create. So I'm just going to add in the month of April into this one. And so that's good to go. And I already have 2 months for my church planner, which is my work planner. I already have 2 months in this particular planner because I'm always planning ahead. So we're just going to skip this section because I don't share much with this particular planner. But this is where I just keep track of all of the bills that I need to cover, payroll, all of the duties that I need to do as the CFO of my church. The next section was my reading section, but I just changed it to my commonplace section. If you guys didn't know about commonplace notebooking or my learning notebook process, I will link that video above. But on top of having a learning notebook or a commonplace notebook, I also wanted a commonplace planner. You have probably seen me working in this planner over the course of the month. This is where I have been adding in just different things that I wanted to talk about with you guys. We talked about 7 money tips that I wish I knew sooner, and we're also going to talk about how to set up your budget for success. I don't believe this video is out just as of yet, but I want to be able to decorate and put down some beautiful stickers and talk about different things with you guys. And so I decided to name this my commonplace section. So this will be the horizontal planner. It was my reading planner at one point in time, but I'm going to switch it over to my commonplace planner. And then for the books that I am reading, I'm just going to add in different insert sheets with the cover and talking about the individual books that I have read for that month. So currently I am reading The Catalyst by Jonah Berger. After I finish that book, I will write up a synopsis on what I think about the book and the highlights of the book and just add it in as an insert. That way I won't feel as restricted as in I have to complete a weekly spread for every single book that I read. There won't be as much pressure. So let's add in the month of April for my commonplace. And then my very last section is my other section. I have a bunch of other things going on in here. I have some insert sheets for when I need to keep track of my daily to-dos. I also have a travel section. That's where I have printed out my tickets and different things for upcoming travel that we have. And you guys have seen our family meeting structure sheet as well. This is the sheet that we use to make sure we're going over these different things for every single time we're having a family meeting. So all of this is working for me, so it's going to definitely stay in here. And then the very last thing I have back here is a calendar. So this is a monthly calendar that I saw in Michael's that I thought would be great because I could just pop it in at the very back of my planner. But once again, I could plan ahead. I could look at different things that are coming up. It's kind of like just another section for my future dated section, but I could also use this for church. With the future dated section, since you guys can see that, I don't usually put anything else in there that might be private information, but in here, I can put additional things since it is closed off and it's not something that you would naturally see. So this is going to be my April setup. This isn't bad, so I'm going to add back the month of March since I have the month of March for all of my other planners in here as well. So yeah, it's super chunky, super, super chunky, but it is still working, it's still closing, so I'm going to roll with it, and if it gets too heavy for me, then I will just take everything out. So this has definitely been set up for the month of April. This has been working for me. The other planner that I have been using that has been working for me is now my family planner. Remember when I set this one up, I set it up as a daily planner, but that was before I got the little notebook that I currently use now. I really decided that I wanted to keep everything in one. I didn't want to have to carry around multiple planners, but when I had this as a daily planner, it wasn't working for me because I had to carry it around. So what I decided to do with this one is create a family planner. So this is now my family planner. I have the entire year in here. It's a vertical style planner. I'm really gonna get into it for the month of April. I kind of played around with it for the month of March and did a couple of things, but I'm really going to get into it for the month of April. I have the calendar at the very front, and then in my notes section, I have my home section, which is my chores, my meal plans, memories, and projects. So we'll go more in depth into this overall planner, but I just wanted to share with you the system that I am currently using and both planners that I am currently using. So this is the one that is my catch-all. It's everything. This is the one that I'm carrying around on a daily basis. This is my family planner that stays at home, but I am adding memories and pictures and a bunch of other things, going into way more detail in this planner. So the personal section that I have in here, that's like an overview of home, health, and family. This one goes into way more detail into family and things and memories and a bunch of other little things like recipes that won't be in this planner. So we'll get into more videos on both of these planners in the next coming month, and I will see you guys in the next video. Until then, keep organizing your life so that you can achieve your dreams. Bye, guys.